And now, live from 1944 in the Soviet Union, it's Joseph Stalin!
Greetings. You know, life of brutal dictator isn't always sunshine and lollipopsky. Sometimes it's lonely job. But when I'm feeling cranky and a little blue, I sit around and consider the many things which make me happy.
Creating terror with government purges, acting out all of his monstrous urges, Big Brother plots that would make Orwell blush.
These are the things that sure give me a rush.
Spying on Lenin and murdering Trotsky, vexing the West with his communist Plotsky, turning your dreams into scary nightmares.
That is the way I forget all my cares.
When the Germans head for Moscow and the weather's vile,
I simply look on as they all freeze to death, and that really makes me smile.
Feasting like Ivan while Serbs live on rations, covering dozens of satellite nations,
starting my own personality cult,
doing away with those who might be fault, sending your critics to rot in Siberia. That's how you get populations to fear ya, leaving you all down the streets of Berlin.
This kind of thing makes me flash quite a grin.
If the people call for freedom or democracy,
I'll simply bump off everybody until there's nobody left but me.
Many years later, when Moses grew up to be a strong young man, he came upon some Egyptians who were treating people very poorly.
You're lazy! Get up! Get up and get back to work right now, or else!
Hello, Lydia Karaoke Network Censor here. I'm afraid this segment, Things I Find in My Pants, is totally inappropriate and unacceptable. We cannot approve of anyone rummaging around in their pants and finding things, whether they're historical or not. This is a kid's show.
Leave him alone. You shouldn't treat anyone like that.
He's pretending he's hungry and tired because he's too lazy to work. I'm teaching him a lesson about...
Leave him alone.
That's why... Who wants water?
I love you!
Okay, Mr. Smarty Pants, you may continue.
It was very unusual for someone to help an Israelite like that. Everyone told each other what happened. Moses was sure he had done the right thing, but he knew the Pharaoh would be very angry. So Moses left Egypt all by himself, knowing that he was really an Israelite. He wanted to go to another land where he would not have to see his people be treated so badly.
You should have seen the one that got away.
Oh, please.
It's true, I tell you. It was yay long. Had to be a 20-pounder for sure.
Yeah, right.
I'm so sure.
Mm-hmm. And that's why we eat rocks.
Yeah, or what if they're wearing sunglasses?
Oops. Uh-oh.
Captain Dude just got nasty.
Well, what do you say, Loud Kiddington?
Can I buy a vowel?
Of course. Now, how about...
Kiss.
So, did you see the dress Cleo is wearing?
Moses is helping the kids escape. Where is he? Where is he? He's around here somewhere. Oh, my. My beautiful princess.
I'm back. Oh, wow. Like, it's really you.
Yup, the job is done. What'd you ask for? That's your great mom.
What the heck?
This is driving me absolutely nuts.
Well, it was worth a shot. Oh, I see.
Got water?
Thank you.
Mamma mia! For such a little boy, you sure got a big voice.
There's a lion loose in the streets!
This sounds like a job for Renaissance Man.
Renaissance Man! He's a Renaissance Man! Everything, every subject he can. He's a Renaissance Man! Renaissance Man!
I've been robbed! Peace! You'll never run, but I need you!
I've been robbed.
Well, of course you've been robbed. Come on, Tamras. Let's blow down Jesse James for Robert Ford.
All right, count me in, Wild Bill Hickok.
One of my bright ideas. Luckily, I made a working model of the parachute.
Redman, you're my hero!
If you want to use the skis, wait your turn. I gotta rent it for another half hour.
Get your blueprints!
There he is, Jesse James. And now, here's the greatest idea. I'll let you go with him and join him when you are master of disguise. I spy with my little eye, which makes you capture Jesse James in the ambush.
Thank you!
Sir, not much. And you? Cool. Nasty head wound rocks!
I've got a million ideas! Let's see. How about this one? This is a new parking zone! This is our radio sign!
Oh, total difference. Bummer.
Well done, Robert Ford. Jesse James, I sentence you to sudden, infant, and even immediate death.
Yeah, Jesse, you are mighty preachy, and you're gonna preach your neck right into the hangman's nose. Another one of my bright ideas, I made the Renaissance birdcage on the dangerous frog.
Well, I give up.
Kept working on the monument. I guess I'm just a chip off the old block.
Renaissance Man, he's a Renaissance Man. He studies everything, every subject he can. He's a Renaissance Man, Renaissance Man.
From the 1860s through the 1890s, millions of cattle were driven north from Texas to Kansas and Nebraska. From there, they were shipped back to eastern markets by train to provide beef for the East Coast. Whoa! With all that cattle going north, one important question had yet to be answered.
Who cleaned up after them?
Not me.
Here's our musical tribute to those brave cow kids who did all the dirty work.
Scoopin', 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 the cattle keep on pooping. Our backs all hurt from scoopin' cow pies. From Texas to Nebraska, the steers don't even ask ya. They leave the pies behind them like landmines. It's our job to pick up. This place could use a stick-up. Ones that smell like flowers or like pine.
That's mine.
Scoop 'em up, pick 'em up, pick 'em up. Scoop 'em up, scoop 'em up, pick 'em up.
Cow pie!
Pile 'em high, toss 'em low, toss 'em low. Pile 'em high, pile 'em high, toss 'em low.
Cow pie!
It comes out, comes out, comes out. By the ton, we're bummed out. The grass goes in and comes out. Cow pies! Don't you wear your new shoes, or you'll be singing the blues when you step in stuff from Mr. Spear. I guess we'll just keep moving. This stinky job is proven. With pies around, you know the end is near. Scoop 'em up, pick 'em up, pick 'em up. Scoop 'em up, scoop 'em up, pick 'em up.
Cow pie!
Pile 'em high, toss 'em low, toss 'em low. Pile 'em high, pile 'em high, toss 'em low.
Well, folks, that's all the time we have left for our tribute to Tyrants on...
Histeria!
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 Histeria, dude!
Histeria!
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 In the 80s, there was Cold War drama.
We fought the commies inside Nicaragua. Our friends were the Contras. Freedom was their mantra, so we sent them lots of money for guns and landmines. But Congress stopped the Contra money flow just 'cause they moved a teeny bit of blow. But then a hero came forth. His name was Oliver North. He and Reagan went around the sissy Congress. Holly North, Holly North. You see, North secretly sold missiles to a harmless country called Iran. Would always be a grateful ally. Then he gave the profits to the Congress. Genius! But the sales were uncovered by the press. Reagan and North began to stress. Because what they did was technically high treason. But it was totally justified. North volunteered to take the blame to save Reagan from
desperation. You are such a grouch!
He did marry with his hot secretary, thanks to her shredder. He got a totally scot-free Holly North. Holly North, he's a soldier
and relaxation,
and a hero, and a novelist. And now he's on Fox News.
Oh, darn, that is the end.
Well, we all loved the Shepherd drawings when we started on the picture, and still do. But you can't take something like that that is drawn only in certain views. We have to be able to draw the character in every position, every view.
And he wanted to be sure that we captured the story, that we captured a strength in the characters so that they would exist on their own. They didn't rely on you having read the story.
Have a beautiful time.